Hello everyone, this is Varshini from final year EC department in Cambridge Institute of Technology. Today, I'm here to present my presentation on microwave oven simulation by Emerzy. Here are the contents. We are going to know in brief about what is microwave oven, embedded systems, requirements, and the softwares used in this simulation. So, introduction. Microwaves are produced inside the oven by an electron tube called a magnetron. The microwaves are reflected within the metal interior of the oven where they are absorbed by food. Microwaves cause water molecules in food to vibrate, producing heat that cooks the food. That's why foods that are high in water content like fresh vegetables can be cooked more quickly than other foods. The microwave energy is changed to heat as it is absorbed by food and does not make food radioactive or contaminated. Although heat is produced directly in the food, microwave ovens do not cook food from the inside out. When thick foods are cooked, the outer layers are heated and cooked primarily by microwaves, while the inside is cooked mainly by the conduction of heat from the hot outer layers. So microwave oven is a basic kitchen appliance that can come in many different sizes and styles. It is mainly used for heating and cooking food. In microwave oven, we have variety of modes, and here we have implemented four kinds of modes in our simulation. That is micro mode, grill mode, convection mode, and start mode. Micro mode, it uses maximum power of 900 watts, and the maximum time you can set for cooking in micro mode is 60 minutes, that is 1 hour. Grill mode, it is similar to micro mode. Here different mode is used for cooking meat and bread, and the timer is set as per our choice or according to what the instructions say for that particular food. Convection mode. In this mode, user can set the oven to preheat for a particular temperature and it takes 3 minutes. So the default time it takes to preheat is 3 minutes, and then it asks for the user's timings of minutes and seconds to heat the or cook food. Embedded system. An embedded system is a microprocessor-based computer hardware system with software that is designed to perform a dedicated function either as an independent system or as a part of a large system. At the core is an integrated circuit designed to carry out computation for real-time operations. Complexities range from a single microcontroller to a suite of processors with connected peripherals and networks. From no user interface to complex graphical user interfaces. The complexity of an embedded system varies significantly depending on the task for which it is designed. Embedded systems application range from digital watches to microwave ovens and all hybrid vehicles. So 98% of all microprocessors manufactured are used in embedded systems. So here we can see the components of embedded system. This is the basic components, the memory, input, output ports, system core, and other devices. These are the types of embedded systems: standalone system, real-time system, networked, and mobile. So for standalone system, the example is semi-automatic washing machine, which is and independent systems, that is it can either automatically take all the actions or some actions are being set by the user. Real-time system would be airbag system, that is, it should not fail at all at a specified time, it should work on time. And network system is like home security system, which is connected to our home automations and stuff. Mobile systems are robots, which is movable. So what to expect from a good embedded system? These are the few features of a good embedded system: low power consumption, cost efficient, efficient use of processing power, reliable, efficient use of memory. So these are the requirements. Knowledge in embedded C. We will be using C language in our simulation. MPLAB IDE. In this software, we are going to execute all our programs. XE8 compiler. PixSimLab. This is the board we are going to use. PIC16F877A. To perform our simulation. 16x4 CLCD. Tactile switch. Matrix keypad and timer to module. Embedded in C. In embedded system, programming C code is preferred over other languages. Because it is easy to understand, it is highly reliable, portable, scalable, and it can be compiled on a variety of computer platforms. Embedded C has many other features. It is pre-formatted language. We have number systems, data representation, integrated numbers, and data types. Data types comes under two categories, integral and floating point, integer numbers and decimal numbers such as float and double. We have other terms such as operators, array, pointers, functions, strings, and storage class. So operators are basically like arithmetic operators or logical operators where you use for conditions and for loop statements. Array is a collection of data of same data types and they are sequential. Pointer parameter passing mechanism in function by passing the reference. String is for characters and ASCII values and characters. Conditional constructs have two iterations, single and multiple. If, if-else, if-else-if and switch cases are all looping statements. And in multiple iteration, we have while, do while and for. They are all looping statements where we can apply conditions so that they can satisfy the conditions and execute the required function. Here we can see data types. It is of integral and floating point. Integral has character and integer data type and floating point has float and double data type. Conditional constructs, if, switch case, for, while, do while, all are looping statements. Here modifiers and qualifiers, these are the sizes of each data type, short, long, 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 signed and unsigned. This is operator description and associativity of arithmetic, logical and relational operators. Microcontroller and microprocessor. Microcontroller is a compact integrated circuit designed to govern a specific operation in an embedded system. A typical microcontroller includes a processor, memory and input-output peripherals on a single chip, sometimes referred to as an embedded controller or microcontroller unit. Microcontrollers are found in vehicles, robots, office machines, medical devices, mobile radio transceivers, vending machines and home appliances. They are essentially simple miniature personal computers designed to control small features of a larger component without a complex front-end operating system. A microcontroller is basically embedded inside of a system to control a singular function in a device, and it does this by interpreting data it receives from the input and output peripherals using its central processor. The temporary information that the microcontroller receives is stored in its data memory, while the processor accesses it and uses instructions stored in it to decipher and apply the incoming data. It then uses its input-output peripherals to communicate and perform the appropriate actions necessary. All the microcontrollers communicate with each other to inform the correct actions. Some might communicate with a more complex and central computer. A microcontroller's processor will vary by application. Option range from the simple 4-bit and 8-bit, 16-bit to more complex 32-bit and 64-bit processors. Microcontrollers can use volatile memory types such as random access memory and non-volatile memory types. This includes flash memory, erasable programmable read-only memory, and electrically erasable programmable read-only memory. Microprocessor. A microprocessor is a computer processor where the data processing logic and control is included on a single integrated circuit or a small number of integrated circuits. The microprocessor contains the arithmetic, logic, and control circuitry required to perform the functions of a computer's central processing unit. The integrated circuit is capable of interpreting and executing program instructions and performing arithmetic operations. The microprocessor is a multi-purpose, clock-driven, register-based, digital integrated circuit, which accepts all the binary data as input, processes it according to instructions stored in its memory, and provides results as output. Microprocessors contain both combinational and sequential digital logic and operate on numbers and symbols represented in the binary number system. So these are the basic buses in microprocessor, where an address bus that sends an address to memory, a data bus that can send data to memory or receive data from memory, a read and write line to tell the memory whether it should set or get the addressed location, a clock line that lets a clock pulse sequence the processor, a reset line that resets the program counter to zero and restarts the execution. Microcontrollers are less flexible and microprocessors are more flexible. This is the architecture of a PIC-SIMLAB. Here, for our simulation, we have used PIC16F877A. Specifications of this particular board, microcontroller board. It has total number of 40 pins and there are 33 pins for input and output. PIC16F877A is used in many PIC microcontroller projects. It also have much application in digital electronic circuits. An EEPROM is also featured in it, which makes it possible to store some of the information permanently, like transmitter codes and receiver frequencies and some other related data. The cost of this controller is low and its handling is also easy. It is flexible and can be used in areas where microcontrollers have never been used before, as in microprocessor applications and timer functions, etc. It has a smaller 35 instruction set. The operating voltage is between 4.2 volts to 5.5 volts. If you provide it voltage more than 5.5 volts, it may get damaged permanently. The maximum current each port can sink or source is around 100 milliampere. Therefore, the current limit for each GP input output pin of PIC16F877A is 10 milliampere. It can operate up to 20 megahertz frequency. CLCD, that is character liquid crystal display. A liquid crystal display is a mode of display used in digital equipment, replacing many other modes of displays such as cathode ray tube, LED displays and plasma displays, often abbreviated as LCD. Liquid crystal displays are a thin flat panel which is made up of several blocks filled with liquid crystals. LCD works either by allowing the light to pass through it or by blocking it. Liquid crystal displays are widely used nowadays in various electronic equipment such as digital clock, calculators, various home appliances, laboratory equipment, etc. Liquid crystals are substances which exist in a state between solid and a liquid. Most of the character LCD module used in embedded systems are 16x2 or 20x4 displays. This means that the LCD displays can display two lines with 16 characters each and four lines with 20 characters each respectively. There are 14 pins for a character liquid crystal display module. It can be of both communication modes, 4-bit mode and 8-bit mode. It is long-lasting and energy efficient. It can display the ASCII character and some special characters. Next is tactile switch. A tactile switch allows electricity to flow in an electrical circuit by manually pressing the operating section. The switch is used to supply input signal to actuate a device or equipment. It is designed with a small footprint suited for mounting onto the surface of printed circuit boards, made for to connect electronic components to form electronic circuits. The switch activates when pressed and then turns off when released. This action is called momentary action and can only be performed at low voltage and low current. There are many different types of tactile switches, also known as tactile push switch or tact switch. This switch is also used to select the mode of operations and to enter the temperature to enter the time in our project. Next is interrupts. An interrupt is a signal to the processor emitted by hardware or software indicating an event that needs immediate attention. Whenever an interrupt occurs, the controller completes the execution of the current instruction and starts the execution of an interrupt service routine or interrupt handler. ISR tells the processor or controller what to do when the interrupt occurs. The interrupts can be either hardware interrupts or software interrupts. Matrix keypad interface. The advantage of a matrix keypad is that use of it will allow the programmer to reduce the number of pins to be used. Here, a 4x3 matrix keypad is used, and there are 4 rows and 3 columns connected to the PIC16F877A. It may look like one needs 16 pin for microcontroller to be connected to the matrix keypad, but practically 16 inputs of keypad interface are possible with the 8 pins of a microcontroller port. All 8 lines can be connected to the same port or different ports based on the application requirement. In fact, 8 port pins of microcontroller are sufficient for a 4x3 keypad interface using rows and column matrix. Matrix keypad interfacing and key press identification can be explained in a step-by-step manner. First, we input high or row pins. When a key is pressed, the corresponding row and column gets shorted. In the second step, a software scans the pins and connects it to the columns. If it detects a high on any particular column, then it is found that the key press has been made on a key in that column. The third step is to figure out which key is pressed exactly. For this, software writes logic on row pins sequentially. The pin of the column on which the pressed key is situated will become high. Keys are identified this way. Interrupt service routine. An interrupt service routine is a software routine that hardware invokes in response to an interrupt. ISR examines an interrupt and determines how to handle it, executes the handling, and then returns a logical interrupt value. If no further handling is required, the ISR notifies the kernel with a return value. An ISR must perform very quickly to avoid slowing down the operations of the device. An operation of all lower priority ISRs. Next is timers. Here in this project we use timer 2 module. The timer is an important application in embedded systems. It maintains the timing of an operation in sync with a system clock or an external clock. The timer has so many applications such as measure time, generating delays. They can also be used for generating baud rates. A normal delay function might be used for loop iterating for a few thousand cycles. But these types of delays need not be accurate, and fundamentally it is not good programming practice. So timer or counter is a software designed to count the time interval between events. It counts the cycle of the peripheral clock or an externally supplied clock. Timer 2 is an 8-bit timer with prescalar, a postscalar, and a period register. Using the prescalar, the postscalar at their maximum settings, the overflow time is the same as a 16-bit timer. Timer 2 is the PWM time base when the CCP module is used in the mode. Timer 2 register is connected only to an internal clock, which is 4 MHz crystal. Interrupt on overflow. It has few registers, T2CON. This register is used to reconfigure the timer to prescalar, clock source, etc. Timer 2, TMR2. This register will hold the count value. When this register equals PR2 register, then an interrupt will be generated and TMR2 is reset. PIR1, this register contains the timer 2 overflow flag. PIE1, this register contains the timer 2 interrupt enable flag. Buzzer. A buzzer is an audio signaling device. It is a small device which may be mechanical, electromechanical, or piezoelectric. Uses of buzzers and beepers include alarm devices, timers, and confirmation of user input, such as a mouse click or a keystroke. In this project, it is used as an indicator when the user input time is over. Applications of microwave oven. Basic applications are reheating food, cooking, disinfect kitchen items, making citrus fruits juicer, heating beauty products, roasting garlic, decrystallizing honey, proofing yeast, and many more. So now we will see the simulation of our microwave oven prototype. So this is the MPLAB IDE version 5.35. Here we have coded the main.c and main.h, that is the source file and the header file. Here is my microwave oven simulation main project with header files and other important files. So this is my code, and now I'm going to build this code. So my build is successful here. So I'm going to run this code in PixSimLab. So this is the PixSimLab PIC16F877A. So we have our four modes in our simulation: micro, grill, convection, and start. I'm going to click on the first option, micro. It uses 900 watts power. So it is asking for a time. I'm going to give 15 seconds. So when we enter our seconds, it is toggling or blinking. And when we enter our minutes, it does the same. So I'm going to clear this and enter 10 seconds to show the micro mode demo. So here the cooler starts running, that is the fan. And we have other options such as start, resume, pause, and stop. To switch on the buzzer.
deep.
Next is the grill mode. It is similar to micro mode. So again, we have to set our time. In micro mode, we can set up to 60 minutes. Here again, I'm giving 10 seconds. Here in convection mode, there is a 3 minutes preheating, so it is asking for a temperature which is of 3 digits. So I'm going to give here 1, 2, and 3 for sample. So now it has taken default 3 minutes for preheating. So here we have used a 16x4 LCD. We have other options such as 16x2 also, which shows only 2 lines. Here we have used 4 lines. So while preheating, the cooler is off. The fan is not running at all. So after preheating, it lasts for the regular minutes and seconds timing to cook descripted foods. So now it is asking for the time which we have to enter in minutes and seconds. I'm going to give again a sample of 5 seconds. Comes to a normal mode. Now the fourth option is start. So when we click on start, it automatically takes a default time of 30 seconds. So if we press the fifth option, that is to pause, it stops the timer. It stops the timer as it is, and then we can continue with wherever we left. Now we have left here with 17 seconds. So if we click the resume button, that is 4 again, the timer will resume. So if we click 4 again, a 30 seconds will be incremented again. So I have clicked twice on the fourth option and it has incremented up to 1 minute. So the default is 30 seconds, and since I clicked it twice, 30 total of 1 minute is added on to the time. Now, what if our microwave oven door is open? When it is open, the microwave shouldn't be running. That's the safest procedure. So if the door status is open, then the buzzer sound keeps buzzing. Unless and until we close the door. So that is done by this RB3 button. And finally, we have to stop the process. We click on to option 6, which stops the entire process of timing. So this was the simulation taught by Emerzy, and we have used a PIC16F877A board for this microwave oven simulation. These are all the modes we have implemented in our prototype, and I've shown a demo of everything. So that was my presentation. Thank you so much.